Basire is introduced here for Kenya. And the third and the final change for Kenya. Hartman Toromba now. Tried to take it, a short one, Jeremiah Baisako with a cross, looking for, it's a long one. And the goalkeeper, Walco Risa, really being very busy there up front, Jakes.
Yeah, he has been very busy, and I think credit goes to him. He wants to play so badly for Namibia. Remember, he couldn't make the squad to the Africa Cup of Nations in Ghana, so the coach giving him a chance to play. Look at Jeremiah Baisako again with a cross it through the heart of the four red shades there, and Risa couldn't really get a final touch there. Still 1-1 here at the Independence Stadium, point apiece, and I think Kenya must be very delighted so far, but there's no time left in this one. Chester, Namibia, they have my sneaky daddy Def. I used to remember those days of Bimbo, Geros Verdien, Eliphaz Shibute, Lolito, Ricardo Manati. We used to get it late here at the Independence Stadium. Well, they used to be called here Slaughterhouse. But Warriors still searching for their first win under coach. The Dutch mentor, it has been very, very tough job for him, Chester, isn't it? I think coaching is not an easy job, Chester, isn't it? If you see one advertised, will you apply for it?
I don't think so, Jake.
you don't want to be the coach going for 8 or 9 games with no win. Wow. But don't forget.
I really thought that this was the chance for Adi chance to register his first win.
But don't forget, the money is always good.
Definitely, but the pressure.
Well, sometimes the money can fix the pressure, isn't it? You need it.
So, as I said, I thought it was a really good chance for Adi chance to register his first win here. All his foreign based players at his disposal, except Oliver Risse and Colin Benjamin, who are injured at this moment. We have to play Kenya at home. Kenya not one of the strongest nations in the African continent. And you really have all the reasons in your advantage to get the 3 points here. Rudolf Besta pushing forward, still Besta finds Kaisep twice a shot, looking for a handball. A referee think twice before taking the whistle out of his mouth. Now this is Omongi. Robert, as the Kenyans now pushing forward. This is Austin Makancha. They're really enjoying themselves out there, the Kenyans, with Patrick Onyango. The way back here, the newcomers, they're really keeping possession now, the Kenyans. This is now Ibrahim Chawanga finds Manti, and that's straight into the hands of Atiel Baha.
Also, it's very important we mention to the fans that next week Namibia will be taking on Zimbabwe. This time it will happen at Harare, the team that they drew 0-0 a few weeks ago and then lost against them at home. So Warriors are really very, very busy. And as you said, 3 points could have been a very, very good way to start the campaign. Let's hope that they can still do it.
This is Richard Galisep now. It's desperate for the Warriors to get a goal. Hartman Toromba looking for Tugela Tieni. Kenyans are there. And one player stayed down. That is Kenneth Omongi. Kenneth Omongi is the man down now for Kenyans. And I know the Kenyans really like the situation, because it's going to take the pace out of the Brave Warriors players.
I think the Warriors technical staff must be asking themselves, what must we do now to win a soccer game? I think the last time that they won, if you remember, it was a friendly against Malawi in Blantyre. I think it was part of a Malawian independence celebration. So if the Warriors don't get a win today, it will be 13 games with only one win and two draws. With three draws and nine defeats, just it's not a good record, isn't it?
Not very good at all, Jake. The last time I remember the Warriors winning at home, it was against Libya.
That was long time ago.
Very long time ago for the AFCON qualifiers. Pinar Besta. This is a long one from Walkoresa. And it's a chance here! Yeah! What a goal! Costa Kaiser have rescued the Brave Warriors!
Oh, yes! Oh, yes, Chester! The coach don't even want to move, Chester! Brilliant! Brilliant! Oh! Well! Who said Brave Warriors cannot score? Well, will it be the day where the Namibian fans start to believe in this team again? Wonderful, wonderful strike by Costa KSF Chester. That was brilliant.
What a goal from KSF. And to the fans here. And there is the goal scorer, Costa KSF, scored the goal. And it's a shot from a distance this time, coming from Patrick Onyango. Jaxi, there's the goal.
Look at it again, wonderful ball there by Risa. Look there, the ball just was there to be taken, and Costa KSF hit that one. As if, oh, boom, I think that was a finish. And the good news is that the two men up front for the Warriors have scored again. And what a time to score, because now we are in injury time.
This is now Rudolf Besta. Tieni Tugela finds Jeremiah Baisako. And it's a long one. Hartman Toromba. And still in play here, Costa Kaiser, the goal scorer. Tieni Tugela. And that one is into touch. Only 3 minutes for the Warriors. Left for the Warriors to celebrate their first victory at the Independence Stadium after a long time. Wow. It's a corner kick.
And also, it could be a relief here for coach. And look at the fans. They say, hey guys, this time we trust and we believe in you. You can do it. Go Namibia, is what they are saying there. Well, it's a corner kick
and it's a time-wasting tactic being used here by Welkoresa. And it's a throw-in for Kenya. Free kick, says the linesman. First win for Ari Chans since he took over the Brave Warriors from the late Ben Babuchile. It's a free kick against the Warriors and the goalkeeper Otieno. Arnold decides to take the set piece as himself and tell everybody to push up front. 3 points is what made us here. And that is the final whistle. And that man in your picture is the man that have scored the winning goal, Costa Kaiser. Brave Warriors have collected the first 3 points of their 2010 AFCON and World Cup qualifiers. The campaign started with a win. It's a right step in the right direction, James.
Oh yes, it is. Look at the players. Finally, they know how to celebrate a win. It has been long, long time ago since this team won a match. And now they have done it. Now they have won it. Now, Ali Chans must be a very, very proud coach. He has said it on the popular show on the NBC soccer show that I'm going to win this one. Check Risa there. Wonderful, wonderful pictures coming from Independence Stadium.
Now we are going on the touchline with Wesley Fries.
All right, welcome back to the Independence Stadium. 90 minutes gone. It's 2-1 in favor of the Brave Warriors. And joining me on touchline, it's the victorious coach, Ali Chans. Coach, Wednesday, we talk about it. We look at the team. We said on paper, we have a winning team. Can they play together? But looks like today, your tactics and your bedroom team has done wonders. Your thoughts on the game?
Well, that's not so difficult, though. If a team win the game, it's 75% by the players and 25% by the coach. If you lose the game, it's exactly the same, 75 by players, 25 by coach. But today, you know, it was a very different team, and we had a very good start, in my opinion. Unluckily, the goal against was a little bit unlucky. And if you're looking that we won today, and Colin Benjamin was not there, Oliver Risse was not there. So I think it's a big compliment for the players.
And quickly, take us through the two goals.
Yeah, we make a lot of training for this kind of goals. That's, of course, easy to say after the game. But we make this last week a lot of training to find Wilco by centering. And luckily for me, and more luckily for the players, that was a big goal.
Thank you so much, coach.
Okay.
All right, that's the victorious coach. And also joining us touchline is the coach of Kenya. And they lost that, but let's quickly talk to Jackie Herche. Jackie, you've seen 90 minutes of exciting football. Halftime it was 1-0, and we're saying, okay, lack of concentration again, the Brave Warriors. But I mean, 2-1, it's good for the road to Angola and South Africa.
It's a very big boost for our nation, and I will really only say thanks to the technical staff and the players. I think there was more kind of a hungry mentality in the last 15 minutes, and we have to thank some substitutions that the SP made. And one way is also to thank the new strikers back that are back in the team, Kaisep and Valko Resser. They are more hungry than any other player for goals, and that's what we need in the Brave Warriors squad. We need guys that can put the goals away for us.
Thank you so much, Jack. All right, that's Jackie Herta. It's all happening at the Independence Stadium. The game has ended 2-1 in favor of the Brave Warriors, and looks like it's going to be very exciting. Let's get the honorable ones more on touchline and said, you, I think your predictions were right, 2-1.
Yes, yes, that's what I said. I predicted 2-1. And that is exactly what they have done. The guys have done, they have made it, they make it. Now, what you are waiting for now, to go forward and see how we can do in this group.
And
we are going to do well.
And the second goal, what a goal.
Yeah, it was a wonderful goal. Very wonderful goal. Very, very skillful done. And I predicted that they will score, will at least win.
Okay.
One.
Thank you so much.
We are waiting for the next team. But I think we'll see what will happen. So they've done it last time they were here. But this time I think we have to make sure. Yeah, this time we have to retaliate.
Thank you so much. That's the Deputy Minister of Youth and Sport. And with that, we're going to cross back to the studio. Thank you so much for watching NBC TV. Until next time, from all of us here, it's bye for now.